Hello friends, now we come to our next lecture. I am Professor G.N. Purohit and today I would talk something about estrus detection in cows in this lecture. You see, when a farmer has a more number of cows, then it becomes very important for him to detect estrus at the right time and get his cow inseminated. Now, there are dairies which have a large number of cows. In the United States alone, the number of dairies having more than 2,000 cows have increased during the recent years. And so, the estrus detection is very important. You see, there can be a large number of approaches for detecting estrus. The physical methods, the visual observations, the record keeping, the heat expectancy charts, and then when you are having a large dairy with a large number of females, you would require marker animals, which could be teaser bulls or steers or gomer bulls. Then heat mount detectors applied on the female cows can be useful, say for example the chocks, the tail painting and the Kamar devices. Then detection of the plasma progesterone could be one approach, and detection of the cervical mucus pattern can be another approach. During recent years, there has been development of many electronic devices, and no single method of estrus detection could have estrus detection efficiency of high percentage. So we need to combine a large number of approaches, which I will explain one by one. Then there had been development of the electronic devices, the vaginal electrical resistance probes, the pedometers, the closed circuit cameras, and the pressure sensitive telemetric devices. The visual observation has been the only method available to farmers by which they had been observing their cows in estrus. But visual observation alone cannot serve the purpose when he has a large number of animals. Visually, cows would show increased physical activity. They would show bellowing, mounting on other cows, drop in milk yield, mucus discharge from the vagina, and redness and swelling of the vulva. You see, a cow which is in estrus would bellow, and then it will become restless and excitable. It will run here and there, and then jump here and there, and this shows that the animal is in estrus. Then cows in estrus would stand to be mounted by other cows, and there will be a clear cervicovaginal discharge. The timeline for heat signs in cattle, heat signs of stands and bellows, smells other cows, headbutts other cows, attempts to ride other cows, but will not stand to be mounted and will have a red, moist, slightly swollen vulva and a clear discharge. This would remain for 8 hours, and these cows are coming into estrus. Then a cow with standing estrus, which will remain from 12 to 18 hours, it will stand to be mounted. It may sometimes ride other cows, bellow frequently, and is nervous and excitable. Then when the cow is out of estrus, it attempts to ride other cows but will not stand to be mounted. It will smell other cows and will have a slightly clear mucus discharge from the vulva. When cows show estrus, you see, a large proportion of cows show estrus from midnight to 6 a.m. in the morning, 43%. Then 6 p.m. in the evening to midnight, 25% of the cows. 6 a.m. in the morning to noon, 22% of the cows, and noon to 6 p.m. During this time, the lowest number of cows, they will show the estrus, only 10%. The use of vasectomized males for estrus detection is an essence at a dairy which is having a large number of animals. And this vasectomized male may be used, or maybe you can use the gomer bulls. The gomer bull is a bull which has its penis deviated to one side surgically, and then androgenized females which have been administered androgens for a period of 2 to 5 weeks can be used as males for estrus detection. Now, simply using the vasectomized males would not serve the purpose, because in a large dairy situation, a farmer cannot be behind each and every cow. So we have to use certain marking devices, and this is one of the marking devices applied to the chin of a bull. And when a bull mounts a cow, it presses hard on her back with his chin, and this will result into release of certain dyes, and a mark would be put on the back of the cow. So these are known as the chin ball marker devices. This device is placed under the chin of the bull, causes pain to be smeared on the back of the cow if mounting take place. The efficiency of estrus detection is around 50 to 70%. Then in New Zealand and in Australia, farmers have been using the tail paints applied to the tail of the cows, and when a cow is mounted by another cow or maybe a detection teaser, then the paint would be rubbed off, and by this they can detect whether the cow is in estrus. Every 21 days you will have to change the color of the paint that is applied to the tail of the cow, and then cows which are huddled together would be mounted by other cows because they don't have any space. So these things have to be kept in mind when using tail painting. Then a paint which is oil bound would place a permanent mark, and one which is water bound would be washed up with the rains. So these things have to be kept in mind. The tail paint should be applied from the base of the tail towards the back, and you can see here a blue color which is applied to the cow's tail, and it would be better to use some fluorescent paints which are also visible during the night hours, because if the cow is totally black and if you use a blue paint, then it would not be visible. Then during recent years there had been development of the pressure sensitive heat mount detection devices that are applied to the back of the cow, and when it is mounted by another cow there would be certain color changes. Kamar is one pressure sensitive device which is used. It has a small place where some colored dye is filled in, and it is applied to the back of the cow, to the tail of the cow, and here you can see when it has been mounted with from another cow or maybe a teaser, then the color would disseminate, and this would result into a red color on the Kamar heat detection. Then a positive response on a heat mount detector is always obvious. Then during recent years there have been development of certain other types of pressure sensitive mounting devices similar to the scratch cards. So Estrotact is one, or maybe the Bovan beacon. This is again applied to the back of the cow, and when it is just mounted by another cow or a teaser, then the color scratches out and color appears on the back on the card. So if this type of color appears, don't breed the cow, because this may be because of certain other things, but this one, this cow needs to be bred. Then tail chalks have been used for a large number of times. The freshly applied chalk positioned between hip bones to vertical descent of the tail would be useful, and this has been used. Again, tail chalks would wash away with rains, and one should be careful. Then milk progesterone test. The assay of the milk progesterone could help in detecting cows which have a decreased progesterone at estrus. The progesterone is at low level just before, during, and just after estrus. Progesterone levels are indicated by a color reaction, lower level, greater reaction. So, but because of the high cost of the progesterone tests and poor efficacy of these tests, and requirement of a daily sampling, and coupled with the errors in the detection, plasma or milk progesterone tests for estrus detection have not become popular around the world. Then the cervical mucus fern pattern, if you just collect the cervical mucus from a cow in estrus and prepare a slide from that, there will be typical fern-like appearance if the cow is at the right time to be mated. This is one slide showing the typical cervical mucus fern pattern. The development of electronic devices, Lidl and Stalab probably were the first to develop vaginal impedance meters or the probes to detect the resistance to the flow of the current by the vaginal mucous membranes. You see, whole blood offers less resistance to the passage of the current as compared to tissues, and this is used for detecting cows in estrus. A small probe is placed in the vagina of the cow and it displays the resistance values when we press a small button. The vaginal electrical resistance of cows decreases at estrus, and so if daily monitoring of cows is being done, then we can detect cows that return to estrus. But because of the daily probing and because of lack of specific chips that can detect the vaginal electrical resistance, these methods have not become popular in large dairy herds. Then a cow or a heifer that is in estrus would run away here and there. It will have increased physical activity, and this can be detected by specialized instruments called the pedometers. The pedometers are small instruments which detect the physical activity of the animal. Pedometers applied on the leg of the cow or on the tied to the neck of the cow have been used in many commercial dairies. These pedometers then convey the message to the computers, and a person can know what is the physical activity of that animal on that particular day. This device is used along with a computer to determine how far an animal has walked or it has traveled the distance. Animals in heat are usually restless and may walk long distances, run here and there, and so they can be detected in estrus. The SCR heat time system is a standalone long distance terminal based system that provides a complete reproduction and health monitoring solution with no PC required. It comprises of a robust multifunctional neck tags that each have a proprietary movement sensor and a rumination recorder. So these types of probes have also become popular in some countries. Then video recording or video camera and recording using a CCTV. This system of recording is unique for round-the-clock observation and data recording of the herd. It's applicable in intensive system of housing. Then the latest in the series is the pressure-sensitive radiotelemetric devices. A radiotelemetric device is applied to the back of the cow, and when it is mounted by another animal, it emits radio frequency waves. The radio frequency waves are received by the base station and then transmitted to the person sitting in the lab on his computer. So all animals that are mounted are being identified. Infrared spectroscopy and magnetic resonance spectra. Infrared spectroscopy and nuclear magnetic resonance spectra are carried out to detect estrus-related changes in vaginal, vulvar and vestibular areas. So some people, they have used this technique. Then the use of sniffer dogs has been common in certain dairies, commercial dairies, where people train their dogs to sniff cows that are in estrus. Based on the pheromones, which are chemical cues that are released in the urine and in the vaginal mucus, people have tried to develop a pheromone-based sensor system. The bovinose is one of that sensor system. It detects the sex pheromones that are secreted by the cow exclusively in estrus. The pheromones are volatile fatty acids, and acetic acid and propionic acid are the principal fatty acids that are released at estrus. And that chip identifies the presence of these volatile fatty acids and knows whether the animal is in estrus or not. So, combining a large number of approaches, one can increase the estrus detection efficiency of its herd and improve the breeding performance of dairy cows. So, thank you very much for a patient hearing. If you like this video, kindly share it and subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much.